They were the pop icons of the 70s. She had a unique voice. He had ambition. Together, they became the sweetest partnership on the American stage. But who were Sonny and Cher behind the scenes? This is the shocking truth about the love, partnership, and business of Sonny and Cher. Find out why one of the greatest duos parted. Sherilyn Sarkeesian, a 16-year-old high school dropout, was dreaming about fame. A naive teenager full of hopes couldn't resist Cupid's first amour. Cher immediately fell in love with Sonny, who shared the same aspirations and dreams. He was 28 and worked as an assistant to a record producer. Cher's beauty blew dozens of men away, but her voice and temper could win over a million hearts. The moment Cher opened her mouth, Sonny knew it right away. They were both young and passionate and wanted to soar high together. Riding the wave of pop music turned out to be hard, and the relationship started to crack. Sonny was constantly cheating on Cher. Cher was heartbroken and could not stand the affairs anymore. She later said, "Stardom made Sonny a huge womanizer. One woman, or even five, was not enough for him." Trying to win her back, Sonny promised her a real family life and proposed to her. Cher was expecting a baby girl and was looking for a chance at a happy family. Singing the duo's greatest hit, "I Got You, Babe," it seemed to Cher that she finally had her man next to her, loving her and taking care of her and her daughter. She had finally reached the fame that she so long looked forward to from a high school bench. But the year 1974 was critical. Cher said that when her romance just started, she was too young and too inexperienced to know who she really was and what she needed. "I could just never, ever talk back to him. And so I never got any of my needs met that weren't what he felt they should be," Cher later said in an interview. Cher revealed she thought about committing suicide when she found out about Sonny's infidelity. Cher vividly recalls her talk to Sonny. The singer thought about jumping off a hotel balcony, but then realized she could simply leave him. "When I told Sonny," he said, "if you leave me, America will hate you and you won't have a job." When she finally understood her own identity, she realized that Sonny could no longer match it. "He was starting to kill my spirit," she said. The singer admitted that she wasn't allowed to do anything except work. The duo was more important than anything else. Maybe Sonny and Cher were too ambitious and energetic to live under one roof. In the early 70s, the Sonny and Cher Comedy Hour became a prime-time TV show. Soon, there was not a single person who did not know Sonny and Cher. Provocative dresses with feathers, fur, and sequins, Cher was not only a music icon, but a style icon too. As her longtime designer said, she had a unique sense of style, color, showbiz glamour, and an outsized sense of humor. She finally became the star she always wanted to. But the joy of her success soon changed into bitterness after their divorce. Even though Cher was the one to initiate the divorce, it was still a heavy burden. "I went to him and said, 'Look, break the contract. Let us drop a new contract. Make it 50-50. You can't tell me what to do anymore,'" recalls Cher. She brought that truth to the light many years later. For 11 years, she never argued with him. Cher recalls that her decision broke Sonny's heart because he loved the duo too much, perhaps even more than she did. She didn't want to be a part of Sonny and Cher anymore. Harsh and straight, Cher told Bono, "The truth is, I'm not so sure we should have ever been husband and wife." After the divorce, they steered their boats in separate ways and started solo shows. Cher's was sailing to success, and Sonny's was sinking. They tried to replicate the success of the Sonny and Cher Comedy Revue, but the audience didn't want the individual Sonny and Cher. The show failed very fast. Sonny opened a restaurant with his savings and married a 22-year-old college student. It seemed that he drifted away from his ambitions and had a calm family life, while Cher was still glimmering on stage in sparkling dresses and mesmerizing shows. But all the grievances disappeared when Cher found out that Sonny tragically died in 1998. Bono's death came just days after Michael Kennedy died in a similar accident. She ended her speech at the funeral saying, "When I was young, there was this section in the Reader's Digest. It was called, 'The Most Unforgettable Character I've Ever Met.' And for me, that person is Sonny Bono." If you like this story, subscribe to our channel and get the best videos about your favorite celebs.